Hi students, last video you have learned about the reason why Mendel's work went unrecognized for 35 years, and also you have learned the three scientists, Correns, De Vries, Shermack, who independently rediscovered Mendel's work. In 1902, due to advancement in the development of microscopy, two biologists, Sutton and Bowery, proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance. This theory was proposed based on the similarities noticed in the behavior of chromosomes and the factors of genes. Now, what are the similarities between genes and chromosome? Genes occur in pairs, chromosomes also occur in pairs. Allelic pairs of a gene separate or segregate at the time of gamete formation. Homologous chromosomes also segregate at the time of gamete formation. Both the genes and the chromosomes, the paired condition is restored during fertilization. So based on the similarities between genes and chromosomes, Sutton and Bowery proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance. The theory states that Mendelian factors or genes are located on chromosomes, and it is the chromosome that separate or segregate during gamete formation and the paired condition restored during fertilization. So according to the chromosomal theory of inheritance, genes are located on chromosomes, and it is the chromosome that separate or segregate during gamete formation and the paired condition restored during fertilization. Following chromosomal theory of inheritance put forward by Sutton and Bowery, in 1907, Thomas Hunt Morgan, T.H. Morgan, father of experimental genetics, used tiny creatures of fruit fly, Drosophila melanogaster, for performing the dihybrid experiments. So Morgan performed dihybrid crosses using the fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster. Now, why did Morgan choose Drosophila for his experimental studies? These flies can be grown on simple synthetic medium in the laboratory. That is, it can be easily cultured in the laboratory. Also, the life cycle of these insects are very short, about 2 weeks. A single mating can produce a large number of progeny flies. Male and female flies are easily distinguishable. Also, the chromosome numbers are very less, just 4 pairs of chromosomes, 3 pairs of autosomes and 1 pair of sex chromosome. So for these reasons, Morgan chose Drosophila for his experimental studies. Now, this Drosophila melanogaster, the normal forms are the wild type and mutants are the other forms. So wild types are crossed with mutant forms. So what are the characters of the wild type? Wild type are the normal flies, have red eyes, brown bodied and long or full wings. So this is a normal Drosophila, wild type Drosophila. Mutant forms, here you can see the eye color is white. Normal Drosophila is having red eye color, whereas the mutant forms are having white eye color. Also the mutant forms have miniature wings. So these are the wild type and the mutant forms. Now, how did Morgan perform dihybrid crosses? He did 2 crosses, cross 1 and cross 2. In the first cross, he selected 2 characters, body color and eye color. The normal body color is brown and the mutant form has yellow bodied. The normal eye color is red and the mutant has white eye color. So he crossed a wild type or normal with a mutant type. In the cross 2, the 2 characters that were chosen were eye color and wing size. You know, the eye color, normal eye color is red in color and the mutants have white eye color. The wing size, the normal wing size is long and the miniature wing is the mutant. So Morgan hybridized brown-bodied red-eyed males. These are the dominant character. with yellow bodied white eyed females. These are the mutant forms to raise the F1 generation. He then intercrossed the F1 progeny. It was surprising to note that the F2 generation deviated from the 9:3:3:1 ratio. That is, the two genes did not segregate independently as what Mendel stated. This is because Morgan knew that the genes for eye color and body color were located on the X chromosome, and since the two genes are located on the same chromosome, the genes are called linked genes, and the phenomenon is known as linkage. So what are linked genes? Genes that are located on the same chromosome. So the gene for body color and eye color are located on the same chromosome, and they are linked genes, and the linked genes tend to move together from one generation to the next generation. So the proportion of parental combinants were much higher than the non-parental combinants. Non-parental combinants are also called as the recombinants. Why the proportion of the parental gene combinations were much higher than the non-parental combinations? This is because the two linked genes tend to move together from one generation to the next generation. And a small percentage of the recombinants are due to crossing over during meiosis. So here you can see cross A and cross B. I already mentioned in cross A, the body color and eye color were taken, and in cross B, the eye color and the wing size were chosen. In cross A, you can see the two genes are located very close to each other. So this type of linkage is called complete linkage or tightly linked genes. Whereas in the cross B, the two genes are slightly far apart on the same chromosome. So they are loosely linked, or you can say incomplete linkage. In cross A, the parental type was 98.7% and the recombinants were only 1.3%. Whereas in cross B, the parental type was 62.8% and the recombinants were 37.2%. So in complete linkage or fully linked genes, the parental combinants are much higher than the recombinants than when compared to the incomplete linkage. So these are the two types of linkage: complete linkage or tightly linked, incomplete linkage or loosely linked. This is a chromosome. On the chromosome, you can see the linked genes are located. The gene for eye color and body color are located close, whereas the gene for eye color and wing shape are located far apart. So here you can see the recombinant frequency is only 1.3%, whereas here the recombinant frequency is 37.2%. So greater the recombinant frequency, more distant the linked genes are. Later, Alfred Sturtevant, a student of Morgan, he proposed a genetic mapping or chromosome mapping, which indicates the location of the gene on the chromosome. It is a graphical representation. Chromosomes are represented as a straight line on which you can mark the genes that are located on that chromosome. And this marking is based on the percentage of recombinant frequency. If the distance between the body color and eye color is 1.3 recombinant frequency, then the distance between the two genes are 1.3 map units. Hope all of you have enjoyed my lesson. If so, please click like, subscribe, and then visit my website www.ranipradeep.com for detailed notes. Thank you.